study, but we dig into
everything. I want to tell you everything too. We have so much to catch up on. The person in need. Bye bye. Yes, I hope you're having a great day. Okay, I'll talk to you soon.
That's so funny. Just really quick. Good morning, you guys. Whoops. It is 7:50. I woke up about like 20, 25 minutes ago, and I'm just doing my morning devotional time, quiet time with the Lord. It's beautiful outside today. It's like really sunny. And I like to just, when I wake up, I usually make a green juice. This is the Athletic Greens. And I'll squeeze some lemon in there, and then I also do like another thing of lemon water with like warm lemon water in the microwave. Teddy likes to sit with me every morning. Right, Teddy? But I, and just in the book of Peter, I just finished it. I had been reading it for about like 3 weeks, honestly, just Peter, 1 Peter and 2 Peter, because I've just been trying to, like, really meditate on them. I just feel like that's really helped me, just not, like, passing through it as quick as I usually do, and just sort of reading it and actually, like, repeating it in my head and, like, letting it, like, renew my mind. And then I usually go, I have the study Bible, so I have the, I have the NIV Life Application Study Bible, which really helps because I'm really just trying to like learn more about the Bible and as much as I like learn as much as I can. And it really helps when it has like all these down here. It's really helpful to be able to like see the like synopsis of like what it's actually saying in scripture, because it kind of just breaks it down into words that are so easy to understand. So it doesn't make the Bible reading like difficult, which also the Holy Spirit also helps you when you're reading it, but yeah, it just really helps me. So I'm reading Peter right now. Well, I just finished it kind of. It's so hard for me sometimes to like move to a new Bible, a Bible book, because I feel like I get super attached to the one that I'm reading and like the season I'm in life and just how much it speaks to me and helps me. So I really just always like to like reread right before I kind of go to a different one. Just because there's such good stuff. Even though it's like 4 pages, this chapter is not long, it's so much good information that it's like I could not just like read one a day, because I like would definitely not really migrate on it, I guess. So yeah, so now I think I'm gonna read John. I don't know why I've just been like in the Gospels, and I also go back and forth between like reading Proverbs like alongside of this. I feel like Proverbs is really good for wisdom, and I wanted to share with you guys something really exciting on my end, something that's like so exciting for my life, I guess, is I got asked to speak for a conference, a youth conference, May 20th, so that's almost like a month away exactly of tomorrow, or this week, and I'm just like so excited, but I'm also obviously trying to prepare in a way of like what like the Lord wants me to say. There's about 2 to 3 speakers, so I'm not speaking too long. I think just like a 20 minute like basically a 20 minute testimony of like, you know, what the Lord's done with me. And I'm definitely called to like the youth, so it's going to be people like, you know, in high school, maybe college, maybe a little bit younger than that as well. So I'm just excited. They just told me to talk about like my own life and what happened to me like in college, just with friends, and just basically like how I could have really went like a completely opposite direction and trajectory, but I didn't, and he saved me from that. But also just like how I needed saving for myself, like things of the world, wanting to, you know, have fame and vanity, and just I know I could have went a different path. So I'm really grateful that God saved me from that, and he really saves us from ourselves sometimes, and he really just is the ultimate healer. So anyways, that being said, yeah, this is what I do in the morning. I spend like 20 minutes, and then I'm gonna make some breakfast. But this is so crucial, like I really have to do this every morning, or I try to, at least if not in the morning, I try to do it like sometime in the afternoon or at night, like if I can, just whenever I get the chance. Like if I can't get it in the morning, I'll do it before I go to bed. yeah, the word is just literal life, so it really helps me. And yeah, so I think I'm gonna do the book of John next. And I like to just take notes sometimes, like on the side, I'll just write some stuff out, like you guys saw here. And then I have a notebook where I do like a gratitude journal, because I think God has really been speaking to me about being grateful and just trying to like find things to be grateful for, like with what I have. Because I, you know, tend to find myself comparing sometimes like what I don't have. And he just kind of brought me back to like a basic gratitude journal. So I've just really been like writing down things and praying things as if I have them also. Like it says that when we go to God to pray with thanksgiving, which means like pray for the things that you, I guess, desire. Pray for the things that you see yourself as healed. So pray like, thank you, Lord, for healing me. Thank you, Lord, for like allowing me to have this job. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity. Even if you don't see it, it's like really moving in faith. So this is what he'll say to me. He'll talk to me in the morning, and then after I make breakfast, I'm going to go for a walk. And then I don't know if I'm taking my off day for working out today or tomorrow. Kind of just depends. I've been feeling really tired recently, and I think it's because I'm getting my period. So I don't know what that's been about, but I went to the gym yesterday and I literally felt like I couldn't move the weight for some reason. So I don't know why. I also could be neat. I don't know. I've been drinking water. I've been eating good. So I think it's just that. My morning so far. What do you have?
But if they don't know they have it, amen. And so like God thinks, and the only way you can do that is by knowing the word of God. It makes you aware that you're thinking something that is not according to the word of God. Then you just replace it with a good thought. Effective is you can't me, but it wasn't, God still loves you. You don't question his love. And so for a year, I had to confess God loves me unconditionally. I would even go sometimes and look at myself in the mirror and say, God loves you. Just say no. Talk out loud. Talk back to the devil. He talks to you. That I was right with God. And so righteousness of God in him. And that is determined by learning how to think and talk right and really believe. I mean, really believe what the word of God says about you. We had an argument, and so I was talking out loud, talking trash about myself. That's right, I'm stupid, never do anything right. Everything's my fault. Can't do anything right. I mess up every day. How many of you ever talk bad about yourself? One of the worst things that you can do is talk bad about yourself. Start believing that God loves you unconditionally and that he has made you right with him. We do things wrong, but there's a difference in your who and your do.
I am currently downstairs filming a podcast. I'm just about to do a podcast. And then I brought some clothes down because I needed to do a little haul for TikTok. And I didn't know if I wanted to do one for YouTube, but I was going to maybe see if I should do a small try-on haul just for spring. Some things that I just have that I think are really cute in spring and pretty. So I thought maybe I could do that. My name is Vanessa. If you guys are new here, welcome back to my podcast. finish the sauna. Changing really quick, but I need to drink so much water because they say you need to drink water to really help replenish anything. Got a good amount of work done, so that's good. And I had seaweed snack. Get a smoothie.